only one keeping the harbor afloat. Well, beside Captain Aaron.
Really?
A pleasure to meet you.
Likewise. I hope the island doesn't kill you quick. Or slow, for that matter. I don't suppose you'd be willing to lend a hand.
I would.
In order to do proper repairs, I need tools. Specialized tools. And they won't be easy to come by. 450 caps if you can, though.
Sure.
Sign me up. I'll help.
Eagle's Cove Tannery. Tools are certain to be there. Now get.
Okay. Who are you?
You're that mainlander who just got here. Better watch yourself, because this island seems and hears everything you do. I should know. I watched the island tear down the greatest family that ever set foot in Far Harbor. It's a tale of greed, lies, and vengeance.
I love it.
Sounds interesting. I'd like to hear it.
I thought you might say that. My family, the Daltons, was the pride of Far Harbor for generations, even back before the war. It was lumber and fishing that made the Daltons rich, but they got greedy, took too much from the island. The island's been getting revenge ever since, killing us off one by one. I'm the last Dalton still standing. Ah, but now our story takes an unexpected turn. A mysterious stranger comes to Far Harbor. Someone strong.
Me?
Someone capable.
Are you talking about me?
Help, the last living Dalton finally has a chance to avenge her bloodline once and for all.
Are you talking about yourself in the third person?
Let me guess. I'm the mysterious stranger who's going to help you avenge your family.
Ah. You're a quick one. Good. You'll need your wits about you, because your part in the story is filled with danger.
Ooh, dang.
The first chapter in our tale of vengeance. That would be the sad story of Freckle-Faced Petey. Petey was my cousin. He was a good lad, never caused trouble. He thought all those freckles brought him luck, but, well... Not so much. He was out foraging at the National Park campground when the island sicked some feral ghouls on him. He's a sneaky bastard when he wants to be. Anyway, he made it back to town, but died from his injuries that night.
Course, yeah, yeah, you'll do that.
Those are still out there, waiting to kill the next poor fool who comes along. Damn shame.
So you want me to go to the campground and kill them?
Those ghouls are as good as dead.
Good, good. It's long past time those shamblers paid for what they did to Petey.
Got it. Kill some ghouls. Okay. So, got some options. Does he?
No more of you mainlanders are coming. Scares a fish.
Oh, for you.
This time. Alone.
Oh, okay.
Well, hello. Hey, Bertha.
You still here for some reason?
Yes. Yes, I am. Okay, so Longfellow's in there, so I have to talk to him. Because he's going to be my inland guide.
You need a room. See Mitch.
Trying to have a conversation here.
Shut your mouths. Open your damned ears. So the fogs are coming for us all. And I can't see any better way of greeting it than to have another round.
Yeah, drink your problems away.
Thanks for the free drink.
Look at you with all your mainland nicety.
I said thank you.
No, drink up. You stay here.
It's a nicety.
The fog will claim you. Might as well meet her with a belly full of fire, eh?
Let's see what you have on tap.
Let's get you liquored up then. Ha!
Do I have anything for you to buy? That. This. And that. These. That. That. Those. Shipment of glass.
Don't like the service. There's the door.
That's interesting. Okay, cool. Unlocked points of interest map markers across the island.
So much knowledge was locked.
Captain Avery said you can get me to Acadia.
Heard there was a scuffle out there. You get your hands dirty?
Yes.
I'm leaving people to their deaths in the fog.
Okay.
I couldn't keep up. The last 5 minutes.
Some parents are worried about their runaway daughter. She went to Acadia, and I need to find her.
Someone's headed for Acadia. There's always a story. Yours worth dying over, huh?
This girl's all her family has. You'd have to be a real wretch not to give a damn.
Some mainlander family ain't no affair of mine.
Come on, give us a break. That girl could be in trouble.
Christ almighty, you've seen better days. Can't imagine living with a face like that. Suppose I'll have to help you out of pity. I can get you to Acadia. But you've got to listen to me. Go where I say, when I say it. Still won't be easy. You stock up on your necessities, Rad X and the like. And then the real work can begin.
Let's go, Longfellow.
Follow me, then.
Actually, how much Radex do I have? 17. I hope that's okay.
Oh, I think Ting likes you.
Oh, the kitty's name is Tink. Come on.
Huh. The mainlander. Great.
Fire your gun a few times and you think you're some sort of...
Uh-huh.
Hey, buddy.
Charity makes you right. What happens next time when you...
Uh-huh. Yeah, I just want to buy some stuff.
Terms, we take the long walk together. So if you're here to buy some ordnance, do your business. Otherwise, take the first boat out of here. Before the children of Adam or worse get you.
Yeah, okay.
Make it fast.
You don't have any Red X. You're dead to me. Okay, well, it's... Here we go. Okay, well, I'm gonna... Yeah, it's starting to get thick. I'm gonna pop some Red X. How about you, how about you actually move, so I'm not doing this all freaking day? Let's show you how mainlanders do it, old man. Oh, nice! Found you! Okay, don't freeze on me in the middle of vats. Stupid game. There you go. Enraging missile launcher. No, thank you. Okay, let's keep moving. Just add salt water. What does that mean? Cook a new recipe. Okay, cool. Come on, buddy.
What was that?
Got you.
fog ghoul. Come on. Packing, old man.
Here's the mountain trail. Stick to this and we'll make it to Acadia. Game trails crisscross the world, so don't be surprised if we got local wildlife to deal with.
Yeah, that didn't sound great. I have a feeling I'm gonna run into one of those. Happen again, so say we all. Aster, what's that good for?
Someone or something else here.
Things really do look like the geckos from New Vegas. Good, they're fighting each other. Ready, Pops?
Gulpers got a fondness for fresh water. Small gulper, the ones in these parts, is a fair challenge. Now the big ones, they can grow 2-3 times the size of a man. Good thing we don't see too many.
Keep going, Pops. So this island is covered in radioactive fog. For some reason.
Stringing one more soul to the damnation, old man?
Well, what have we here? Another rad worshiping lunatic. That's what.
Yeah, I'm with you.
I am shielded by my faith.
How about bullets? Faith shield you against those too?
Let's just settle down, okay?
You're right. Waste of ammo.
Do not sully this one with your blasphemy, old man. You. I suggest you go no further. Acadia is a nest of snakes. Beasts that subvert the will of Adam.
How do they do that?
What's Acadia done to make you distrust them?
They supply Far Harbor with the means to turn back Adam's holy fog. You'd do well to avoid such creatures. And instead, seek the only true master of this land.
All right, I'm listening. Tell me about Adam.
Tell you? Look around. You stride through his kingdom. A land blanketed beneath sacred fog. A land Adam has claimed for his children. And you may join our family if he deems you worthy.
Really?
Worthy? What do I have to do to join?
There is a ritual his children must perform. If you succeed, you will be rewarded with entrance into our family.
Really? Those are my options?
Okay. Sign me up.
Excellent. Head to the nucleus. There, Adam's plans for you will be revealed.
You're done wasting time with a fanatic.
I am. Let's go. Come on.
Up ahead, the air is clean. No fog. Acadia is not too far now.
Now this looks promising.
And we've arrived. Acadia's already been watching us for a good spell. If you want to talk with them, just go inside. They'll be waiting for you. You need my help again. You come see me.
He's a companion now.
Good place to tool up your gear. Get some rest. Or get stinking drunk. Just make sure if you're bringing a bottle of something strong, there's enough to share.
Leaving already? Don't you want to see what happens next?
You saying you want me to stick around and watch your back?
Maybe later.
All right. I'm serious about the offer. You ever want to hunt the forests and waters of the island together? I can think of worse things to do.
He likes me. He really likes me.
Understanding, peace,
While you're here in Acadia, Synthkind welcomes you as long as you welcome us.
I came here looking for Kasumi Nakano.
Really? I'm impressed. Few would brave the kind of journey you've had for the sake of someone else. Kasumi is here. She's safe and unharmed, and you're free to see her if you'd like. Before you do, though, tell me, do you think Kasumi is a synth?
We're not answering any more questions until you play straight with us. Just who the hell are you, really? There's only one synth with that kind of face and a mind of his own. And I only see him when I look in a mirror.
Nick? It can't be you.
Don't give me that. What are you trying to pull? I've never seen you before in my life.
Please, if you're willing to give me a chance, I can explain.
Yeah, why don't you explain?
Is this a joke? Do you really know Nick?
Let me tell you what I know, and you can judge for yourself. We were prototypes, Nick. The first synths capable of independent thinking and judgment.
Keep talking.
One of the Institute's experiments had to do with how our brains could process personality. If we could handle individualized feelings and behaviors, I was allowed to develop mine based on experience. But with you, they wanted to try transferring an entire personality into you. It took several attempts before the personality imprint worked. I saw you wake up not knowing who or what you were so many times. I couldn't let them do it to you anymore. We were the only two prototypes they made. I literally saw myself in you. You were my brother, Nick. I helped you escape the Institute. We left together.
If I were your brother, I'd remember.
That's where you'd be wrong. This happened over a century ago. There's only so much memory that can fit into the prototype brains we have.
I've heard enough.
I think you and I need to talk about this. Maybe not now, though.
We'll talk later. This is a lot to take in.
Nick, I don't need you to believe me. I'm just glad to see you again. Whenever you're ready, I'll be here. Now, about young Kasumi. It's important that you understand exactly why she's here. I asked you before if you think she's really a synth. If you could indulge me with an answer.
Who or what she is isn't important.
But it is. It's everything. Imagine just looking at your own hands and having to wonder, was I born with these, or were they manufactured? None of us take this transition lightly. She's facing the possibility of her entire life being a lie, that someone stripped her very identity from something she isn't. I want you to understand that before you see her. She has a chance here to live as a synth, not hiding, not pretending to be something else. One more question, if you'll indulge me. You're here for Kasumi, but I suspect there could be another reason you came to us. Tell me, are you a synth?
I'm a human being, not a synth.
Are you sure? I don't mean to question you, but what's the first memory you have?
I was with my wife. We were getting ready for the day. I had to take care of my boy, Sean. A lot's happened since then.
But no memories before then? no childhood. Your first...
Come on, game.
Your first kiss? That's usually a sign. Data is easy to migrate, but feelings... That's a hard thing to transfer into another mind. Isn't it funny how a memory can feel like a whole different reality? People, places, even sounds and colors can change. Or someone else has changed them. I won't lie to you. There will always be other explanations. Trauma, disease, the background radiation. They all take their toll on the mind. But I can promise you that you will be accepted here. Whatever you decide is true for yourself.
I've heard enough. Where's Kasumi Nakano?
Of course. Kasumi is usually working down below. You can see her whenever you like. Acadia is open to you. Feel free to walk the grounds. Introduce yourself to my co-founders, Faraday and Chase. Did you need anything else before you go?
I'm part of a group that helps since. The railroad.
Really? I don't understand why a group dedicated to helping synths would convince them through fear that their only option is to hide. Yes, they volunteer for the memory wipe. Yes, not knowing you're a synth makes it harder for the Institute to find you. But the cost, I know how frightening it is, the risk of capture. Sacrificing what you are, avoiding the true struggle to be accepted as our own form of life.
I'm not talking a lot because this is pretty good dialogue. I'm enjoying it.
Are you saying you don't want the railroad's help?
It's not about that. It's about how you've let fear blind your cause.
Thought about it like that. I'm sorry.
So am I. Your heart is in the right place, and it's unfair of me to judge. While I enjoy relative safety from so far away, was there anything else I can do for you?
Who are you? What's your story?
I came to this island over a century ago, hiding from my creators, the Institute. But after my escape felt secured, I was left with nothing. No programmed task. No false memories. I spent a year just sitting in a cave. Just sitting. One day, it finally occurred that maybe I could decide for myself what to do, who I was. I've been doing that ever since. Was there anything else?
So, everyone here in Acadia is a synth?
Yes. Either they were escapees we managed to find before the Institute could, or they were victims of a mind wipe, and we revealed the truth to them.
I should get going.
Of course.
It's weird that it gives the I'm in the Brotherhood option, because I'm not actually in the Brotherhood. Definitely stuff to loot.
I have a hard enough time keeping up with repairs before all this nonsense with the Atom Lunatics.
They're nothing you need to be concerned about.
It's not them. I'm concerned about you, Dima. You can't solve all the world's problems. Certainly not all at once.
Dearest Faraday, relax. All will be fine.
So, you've talked to Dima. You know why we're here. I certainly hope that you'll consider helping us. Dima's vision is worth fighting for.
You're right. It is a good cause. Synths definitely deserve to be safe, just like everyone else.
It's so good to hear that. Very encouraging. Please, make sure Dima knows that as well. He's put so much of himself into this. All his time and energy devoted to helping others. He never stops to think of himself. Sometimes
sure.
I worry about... Well, if I wasn't here to make sure his equipment is all functional. And that's not even mentioning maintaining the fog condensers. So many things to keep track of.
Fog condensers?
Seems like he's lucky to have you helping.
Thank you. That's very kind.
Can you tell me about the fog condensers?
Oh, those? Dima and I designed them when it became clear the fog was only getting worse. They're effective, but have such a limited range. Dima insisted we provide them to the people of Far Harbor, and I'm so glad we did. Without the condensers, I'm not sure they'd have anywhere left.
Dima looks like he's had a lot of work done.
Well, that's certainly an understatement. Between the two of us, we've made so many modifications. He was just a prototype, never built for all this. It took a lot to overcome the limitations of the original design and expand his memory. It really is remarkable, isn't it? He's overcome so much. He's become so much more than he once was. And all he thinks of is others.
Sure.
If there's anything I can do to help out, just let me know.
Well, if you're determined to help, there is something you could do. It's likely somewhat dangerous, though, so I understand if you'd rather not. There's a boat along the coast of the island. It was transporting some hardware we needed. Storage drives. The boat never finished the trip, you see. So the drives are still out there. I could really use them here for extra parts, if nothing else. My understanding is that the boat wrecked southwest of here. So, does this sound like something you could handle?
Certainly.
What happened to the boat? Why didn't it make it?
I'm not entirely sure, to be honest. Trappers, fog crawlers, there's no end to what's out there. And what might still be out there. But the point is that we already lost someone once. I don't want to see that happen again. So, are you up for it?
Sure thing, Faraday. I'll get the drives for you.
Thank you. I really do appreciate it.
Hey.
I'm all ears.
Hey.
What? Oh, sorry. Got my head full of what Dima was talking about. It's a bit of a shock. What do you think he is, really? Family?
Before I answer, are you okay?
I'll keep. Don't worry. Just need to figure this all out.
It's hard to deny it, Nick. The similarities are pretty obvious.
I spent a long time wondering if the Institute had made any other prototypes. If I was just a failure, they gave up. Just plain got bored. I always thought I was just more of their discarded trash. I never thought of the possibility that someone wanted me out. Helped me escape. There's got to be some kind of proof out there. What really happened between me and Dima? I'd appreciate it if we could keep an eye out.
Certainly.
Of course, Nick. We'll find something.
Thanks. I know we don't have much to go on. Just keep me in mind if you find something that might give us some answers.
Yes. That is a thing that I will do. Yeah, let's just put our bullets in the cooler.
Thank you.
Kasumi Nakano?
Sorry, I'm right in the middle of something.
Your parents sent me. They want you to come home.
They did what? You came all this way for me.
You left without telling your folks why. You must have known they'd be worried.
Look, my mom and dad... those people that were taking care of me, they wouldn't want me back. Not if they knew the truth.
Because you're not really their daughter, Irisin.
Yeah, exactly. I thought if I just left, it would be easier for them. How would that conversation have gone anyway? I've been lying to you this whole time. Your real daughter is dead and I replaced her?
You haven't replaced anyone. Kenji and Rei are still your parents.
Look, I get it. They hired you to bring their daughter back. And I wish I could. I really do. Acadia isn't what I thought it was. There's more going on than just the refuge. I can't leave until I've gotten to the bottom of it. I've been running for long enough.
What kind of problem is there in Acadia?
It's a long story. I just have to figure out how to... Wait. Wait, you find things.
Yeah.
Answers. That's what you do, right?
That's what I do.
That's why you came after me. What if I told you that there's a secret? A big secret here on this island.
Something I would not be shocked.
Than just one lost girl.
Not shocked at all.
All right. I'm listening.
Okay. Where to begin? You saw all those computers that Dima's hooked up to, right? They hold his memories or offload data from his brain. Or maybe some combination of both? Well, Faraday asked me to help do some repairs on them. And, you know, I got curious. There's like a century's worth of life experiences in there. And that's when I see it. Data models Dima has been making. One was the fog taking over Far Harbor. Another was a nuclear detonation on the island. Plus, death counts. What if Dima is so open and welcoming because he's actually hiding something from us? A plan to wipe out the rest of the island.
We should get to the bottom of this. If Dima is putting on an act, we need to know.
I'll help if I can. That's not much to go on.
I know. I've been working on that, but I haven't had much luck. I keep seeing Dima, Faraday, and Chase head into the laboratory at the other end of the hall. Then they come out later looking like they've been arguing. There's actually a storage space right next to there. It'd be a perfect spot to hide and eavesdrop, but it's been locked up. I've also tried breaking into Faraday's terminal, since he and Dima are so close, but the security on it is crazy.
This'll be easier if I just talk to Dima. Convince him that he needs to be honest with us.
All right. Good luck. Let me know what you find out.
From one case to a new one. It's never easy for us, is it?
I swear someone has the key to that storage room. Maybe Cobb? He's always moving supplies around as they come in.
Okay, I need to put on my talking outfit. Aren't I spiffy?
Katie is far away enough from the Institute that we don't have to worry, right?
Probably. Stuff to loot.
You want me to take a look at that terminal? You just say the word. No, we're out of way with machines.
Yeah. So much to loot in here. None of it's owned. Yes, rat. Really? Really? Yeah, Nick, take some of.
Hey.
There's something you need?
Seriously? Seriously? Oh my god. What are you? You're the lock on the door.
Loctite. Heads up.
I'm listening.
Go check that out.
How about we try something else?
Okay, fine. Don't do your freaking job. I don't need you, Valentine. Do it myself. Leave your ammo wow.
So you're that new fellow from the Commonwealth. It's so wonderful to meet someone from back home. I'm afraid Kasumi doesn't seem to want to discuss it, but how are things there?
Getting better every day, I think.
Oh, that's so good to hear. I would like to see it again someday, once things settle down here. Acadia is all well and good, I suppose. But honestly, it does get a bit boring.
You're safe here. That's what really matters.
I suppose. One could do with a little excitement now and then, though. Don't you think? I'm sure I'll see you around. Do take care.
You're new here too, huh? I mean, I haven't been here that long myself. Honestly, I'd be dead right now if it weren't for Chase. Turns out it's pretty hard to live as a synth in the Commonwealth.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm sorry to hear that you suffered.
Thanks, but it doesn't matter now. I'm here, and I'm safe. I'm never leaving. I'll see you around, okay?
Okay. Bye.
One day, I'm gonna get out there and see the rest of the world.
Hey, Nick.
Heads up.
Do something?
Scrap run.
Hey.
I'll see what I can do.
Over here.
Good thing. Whatever you need.
Okay, fine. You don't have any armor. Oh, that's the armor station. Need adhesive. I have to be able to find some duct tape around here. Under glue.
That's a good attitude. Hope can get you through the worst of times.
Believe me, I know. When I first escaped, I had no idea what to do with myself. I was so lost, so scared. But I heard rumors of Chase, what she was doing, that she was bringing people to a safe place. A place just for us. And now here I am, for all it's worth.
You're lucky to have found a place in the world.
Yeah, I guess. This just wasn't where I thought I'd end up. Any of it. I've just gotta keep telling myself I'm better off here than dead.
It's true. You do have to tell yourself that. So much duct tape just lying around.
Most of us would probably be dead.
What's down here? Oh, it's just the workshop.
Look alive.
What's the plan? Think you can unlock that terminal?
Serious subroutines running on this box, but maybe not that either. Slightly different approach. Nope. Dang. Locked down too tight.
Well, darn. Okay, what raises my charisma? One for a dirty wastelander. One for a glint stout. Two for an XL.
Says she's seen parts of your memories. Death projections. For Far Harbor and the center of the island.
That's unfortunate. She should be focusing on herself. Her new life. She shouldn't have to bear the burden of the outside world. Please. This is a matter best left to me and my advisors. We aren't planning to destroy the island. Those projections were merely to help us realize the cost of inaction.
Just a handy reference, huh? Expect us to just take your word on it?
If this thing involves the whole island, then you need help. I can be your problem solver if you let me in.
I suppose there's something to be said about refusing help, even when it's offered and you're in need. There's a conflict that's been brewing on this island. Shortly after we built Acadia.
between Far Harbor and the Children of Atom?
Simply put, they want to kill each other, and each side wants us to help them.
We've tried to stay neutral, but Far Harbor was going to be wiped out by the fog, so that's when we built the condensers for them.
And I was friends with the previous leader of the Children of Atom, Confessor Martin. I even gave them their headquarters, the submarine base they named the Nucleus.
Which was a mistake, because Martin is gone and the new Confessor, Tectus, is completely insane.
He's been threatening us.
That sounds like the Children, to choose a son. But in general.
I left behind something very important in that submarine base I gave them.
Dima's earliest memories are stored in the military computer banks in that base. Pre-war security systems and Confessor Martin's goodwill were supposed to keep them safe.
But now Tectus is in charge, and he's after Dima's memories. We don't even know what's in them.
But we do know that I spent nearly a century on this island alone. Whatever's in there is too dangerous to allow Tectus to get his hands on them.
You left your memories behind? How does that work?
As a prototype synth, my raw data capacity is limited. I began using computer banks to expand, to give me room to ponder, see new things. I had to leave some of my
earliest memories behind. That sounds like a great idea.
I left the sub base to the Children of Atom. I thought they were safe.
So what can I do to help?
If you're willing to retrieve what I've lost and bring my memories back to me, then we'd all be one step closer to solving this conflict without bloodshed.
That'd be great.
To get through the Children of Atom's base. You're new on the island, so you might be able to pose as a recruit.
Then, once you get to the memory banks, you'll have to use a special program Dima and I have been working on to break through the security systems.
It's not going to be like a normal hack. You'll be breaking through a version of my own mental network. It'll consider you to be an intruder. I've loaded the program with some instructions I've recorded that will help guide you through it. I'm afraid it's difficult to explain without seeing it for yourself.
I'll get your memories, Dima.
If we're lucky, the pre-war defenses have kept the Children of Atom at bay. But that means you'll have to get past them yourself. One more thing before you leave. Whatever you do, don't assault the Children of Atom directly. Our ultimate goal must be to bring peace. If you attack them, they'll consider themselves at war with the outside world.
If we find anything suspicious in those memories of yours, we'll be back. Count on it.
Hey, let me ask you.
Sure, ask away.
It's just, with everything that's happened with you and your family, it's a whole hell of a lot to process. I wanted to make sure you're holding up all right.
Oh, Nick, you trust me more?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Huh. You're tougher nut than I thought. Tougher than I was. Took me a long damn time to get a feel for this place. Thank goodness I found Diamond City. It's got its flaws, sure, but it beats the hell out of anywhere else in the Commonwealth. Of course,
okay.
Up there,
this is a weird place to be having this conversation.
Just as scared of the Institute as they are now. Maybe more. The massacre of the CPG was still pretty fresh in people's minds at that point. Folks were still losing sleep over the broken mask. Plenty of people assumed I was just a saboteur.
CPG?
To melt down the reactor or poison the drinking water. But at the time, they couldn't exactly turn me away.
Massacre of the CPG? What's that?
The Commonwealth Provisional Government. Years back, a group of settlements tried to get together and form a coalition.
Hey, that sounds familiar.
Even a hint of clout sent representatives to try and hash out an agreement. Only the Institute sent a representative of their own, a synth. The man killed every rep at the talks. The Commonwealth Provisional Government was over before it even got off the ground. I took up in town not long after. Damn lucky they didn't just tell me to scram right then and there.
Broken mask?
This was long before I'd moved to town, but apparently some gentleman type shows up in Diamond City, heads down to Power Noodles,
guess he didn't like the food because he pulled his pistol and opened fire on the folks enjoying theirs. When security finally put enough holes in him to drop him, they say he was full of servos and sprockets, just like yours truly. Seems he malfunctioned and went berserk. It was the first time people realized that synths had stopped looking like me and started looking like them. Considering what these folks went through, I felt real lucky they let me in the front gate at all.
Yeah, what's up with that?
Why'd they let you in?
Because I'd rescued the mayor's daughter, a gal of about 15, pride and joy of the mayor back then, and by the name of Henry Roberts. The young Miss Roberts decided she'd run off with some caravan hand she'd known for an evening. Turns out the guy was part of a gang of kidnappers. I didn't even know who I was rescuing, just stumbled on a crying girl and four toughs. I took her home and the mayor dubbed me a hero, offered me a place in town. Lots of folks protested, said I was a spy, but he wouldn't have it. Taking up in the city was tricky at first, but I never tried to hide what I was, and people seemed to warm to that.
You took down four guys by yourself?
I didn't have to. Back then, synths were even more of an unknown quantity than they are today. I told them I was rigged to explode and started going beep, beep, beep. Hardest part of that rescue was people laughing as they climbed over each other to get away.
Oh, Nick, I love you.
Was it hard settling in?
Well, they sure didn't make it easy.
Hello in the chat.
Doing the jobs no one else wanted.
Please feel free to chime in.
Being Diamond City's handyman than I ever did living out in the ruins. But I guess folks never forgot I rescued the mayor's daughter, so they started coming to me when people went missing. Wife runs off with a new paramour and takes the rent money with her. Talk to the
If you're just joining in, I'm in Far Harbor, but I think Nick likes me a little bit better, so he's having his little confident speech.
Go get Nick. After a while, the jobs got so backed up, they didn't even ask me to do the handyman stuff anymore. Hell, I was so happy to do it, it was months before I started charging anyone. I never stopped being Nick the Synth, but it was Nick the Detective folks came to see. It was about then that things finally started feeling normal. It took me a long time to realize that home is where you make it. And with some time and effort, this place can be home for you, too.
Yep, story. Once again, this is a weird place to be having this conversation.
Want to get moving?
Awesome. Okay, they want me to go talk to Kasumi about what I found out.
I assume you're not planning on staying.
Hey, girl.
Turns out Dima's earliest memories are in the hands of the children of Adam. He's afraid of what they're gonna find.
So, is that what those death projections were about? It wasn't Dima planning to destroy the island. He's worried the children of Adam will. Or is he still hiding something? What could be in those memories that he would leave them behind?
I don't know.
Really something in them that's dangerous?
Almost certainly.
Into his memories? Assuming you can get past the children of Adam, of course.
I got this program that Faraday and Dima wrote. It's supposed to help me access the memory banks.
Really? How would that work? When I was taking a peek in the computers he has here, Dima was hooked up to his chair. I was just tapping into it. I wonder if you'll need to, you know, connect to the old banks the way he does? Some kind of connection between your head and the computer. Oh, but that's it. And then Faraday's program would be translating Dima's thoughts and data, helping you through any security guarding it. I'm sorry, I'm making assumptions. It's just, well, it's a little exciting, isn't it?
I'm sure it'll be a delightful minigame.
I'll keep an eye on things here.
I'll get Dima's memories, and then... then we'll figure things out from there.
Good luck.
Come on. Woohoo! Gotta take that. And that brings my knuckles up to 53. Respectable, but you know, apparently not as much as my large meat hook. Wait a minute, is the meat hook a melee weapon? The meat hook's an unarmed weapon? Oh yeah. Oh, that's my new best friend. Oh, it's a punching weapon. Oh yeah. I didn't realize that. Oh, that is sweet. I'm gonna go mess some stuff up. Again, remember how to get out of here. What do I want to do first? Hey Chase, what do you need?
Excuse me.
You track Kasumi here. I'm impressed. Perhaps not as quietly or efficiently as possible. But thankfully, she was never in any real danger. I'm afraid your journey was unnecessary.
I wanted to see for myself that she's safe.
You have my word. Acadia is a safe haven for synths. Were it not, I would not have aided anyone in reaching it. Every synth I've tracked down, every synth convinced to come here, has been assured that he or she will come to no harm. My job is to make sure they all remain safe, no matter what. Understand?
How do you manage to track down synths and bring them here?
I have a network of contacts throughout the area. Some from my time with the Institute, some after. I know the Institute's tactics, and use that to my advantage. You have Dima's blessing, so by all means, make yourself comfortable.
I'd like to help you all. Is there anything I can do?
Actually, as a matter of fact, there is. If you're serious about contributing, well, we've got a situation I need someone to look into. You've had some experience traveling around the island.
No,
so
I haven't.
Decently equipped to handle it.
I took one road.
All right, I'm listening.
We were expecting a new synth to arrive, and he should have been here by now. There's been no sign of him, and I'm concerned that he might have become lost on the way here.
I'll find out what I can.
You should start by talking to Brooks in Far Harbor. He's one of us, a synth. He's the one who meets the new arrivals and gets them started on the journey here. Of course, he's not likely to tell you anything without proof that you're working for me. If he doesn't cooperate, tell him that his designation is L792. That should convince him. That's as much help as I can give you for now. Please, hurry. If that synth is out there alone, he won't last long.
Fascinating. Let's go deal with some ghouls. That sounds like a nice, clean, up there. Well, no time like the present, eh? try out this meat hook. Till I get my meat hooks in him. You ready to F some stuff up, Nick? Turbine. Some more Radex going. Wow. There we go. You tripped! Oof. Oh, I like you, meat hook. Oh, right outside. Awesome. Walking in a straight line. Gonna walk in a straight line. sleep. Oh! Nice. Chameleon reinforced combat armor left leg. Yeah.
Hey, toss anything you can't haul my way.
Yeah.
Yo,
psst, you need to carry some of this stuff. Oh, I need to put my armor back on. Stay out of the lake. Okay. Well, I can return to Cassie. I assume she's going to have another step in her mission. Oh, laser musket. You're such a silly invention. Pearl. Yes, me. You are. I am.
I guess you could say that.
Oh, wonderful. I wasn't sure how I was ever going to find you.
Sounds like we may have another case on our hands.
I haven't been able to find any of the local police force. The louts. I don't want to start a panic, but, well, we may have a murder on our hands, and we need an outside set of eyes.
What?
Where did the crime take place?
At the Cliff's Edge Hotel, just north of the town. Will you help us? There may still be a murderer at large.
Who's the victim?
Well, we want to keep this out of the tabloids, but it's Ezra Parker, the financier of the hotel. Please, you must help us. Every moment we wait, our residents are at risk.
Who are your employers?
I'm not at liberty to give out my employer's personal information, but you will, of course, be meeting with them if you take the case. Will you help us solve this heinous crime?
Okay, I'll help.
Oh, thank goodness. Shall I guide you to the Cliff's Edge Hotel now?
Go ahead. I'll meet you there.
Very good. I shall meet you at the main entrance to the hotel.
Awesome.
It's time to settle accounts. You hear me, Island? My friend here is gonna even things up.
Yes, I will fight the island for you, crazy woman.
The hero of our saga returns triumphant. I bet the island didn't see that coming.
You're a little insane, aren't you?
Here's 200 caps for you.
I wasn't looking to get paid. I'm just happy to help you out.
You're a good person. I can see that. I've been thinking about what's next. And it came to me. We all love our grandparents, don't we? Kind, gentle, doting, love to spoil you. You'd never want something awful to happen to them. Nobody would. That's why it broke my heart when I lost Grandpa George.
I'm sorry. You must have been very fond of him.
Everybody was. But that didn't matter to the island. Oh, no. He was cursed the moment he was born adult. He had a farm, little ways north of here. Lived a peaceful life, working the land, and not causing anyone trouble. The island sent something after him. A huge monster, mean as spit, and with claws to snap steel beams. A fog crawler. Grandpa bravely stood his ground. A shotgun in his hands, holding off that terror while the farmhands fled back here. If you can take out that Shellback Devil, it'll send a message loud and clear that says the Daltons never forget when they've been wronged.
Really? Really? You lure me in with an easy ghoul hunt, and now you want me to go after a fog crawler? I don't even know what a fog crawler is.
That fog crawler's gonna pay. For Grandpa George.
That's the spirit.
Ooh, a cooking stove.
your loved ones with my fine hands.
Whenever you're ready.
I need to talk to you about our missing synth.
Yeah? Well, it's not something I talk about with outsiders. So you can either buy something or move along.
I'm working with Chase. She told me that your designation is L792.
Okay, I believe you. Keep it down, all right? It's real private information. I know the synth you're talking about. He's a younger guy. Maybe early 20s with white hair. Goes by the name Derek. Thing is, he showed up way earlier than he was supposed to. Thought a courser was on his tail, so he rushed the timetable. To be honest, the guy was a wreck. He was scared shitless, looking over his shoulder every 5 minutes and attracting unwanted attention. Tried to calm him down, but he panicked and ran off into the fog. That was the last I saw.
Nice.
Can you tell me anything else? I'm gonna need more information than that if I'm gonna find this synth.
I wish I had more to give you. He disappeared into the fog, and I haven't seen him since.
Relax. I'll take care of this.
Sorry. My nerves are a little shot right now. Look, if you're really going after that synth, I'm pretty sure he took the road south out of town. Maybe you could head that way. Just be careful out there. And thanks. There aren't many who'd go out in the fog to help a synth, especially one they don't even know. I feel like shit about what happened. I really do. I hope you can make it right.
Wait, Brooks. You have a shop.
Welcome to the bait shop. If you need any odds and ends, I'm your man.
Let's see what you have.
Happily. Oh.
Well, I think I'm gonna wrap up here. I did a nice little amount here on the island today, but I think that's it for now.
We live another day.
That's true. We do live another day. I will be back here probably Saturday in the morning. If you can. Join me then, that would be great. But until next time, thanks a lot for watching. I will see you later.